have nothing to say about something good.
My question wasn't a requirement, it was just a, get out there.
And we expect some pushback on this. This is a big project, and if it were in my backyard, I'd be doing as much research as possible.
I can't think of many campgrounds in the state that have that many sites. That's a lot.
Actually, it's.
Maybe Sebago.
190 Fishing.
We want to help draw people to this town.
Not huge.
In Maine?
In Maine, yeah.
Well, those size sites for that many is kind of big.
Well, you've got the space, you know, it's not a larger, right? I mean, you go to camping in larger, you expect you're going to top of Maine. You go camping in Parsonsville, Maine, you want trees.
Yep.
You know, that's what they're going to be able to deliver.
The surveyor was actually saying that he may be able to get as many as 300 sites in this thing. So just, I just want to be upfront with that. And that's not something we could do right out of the gate. I mean, that many sites, you're looking at about a $6 million build.
Right. Oh, yes.
You're always looking at a couple of them.
So this, with, just with a couple of 100 sites, you're still looking at $4 to $5 million. So it's going to have to be done in phases anyway.
Oh, yeah.
You know, infrastructure, first set of sites, second set of sites, you know, and turning it over. And then all the stuff we want to bring in for amenities and, I mean, the river is the real amenity.
Yeah.
Right?
It's a big attraction.
Nice big lazy river, which by the way is the name of our company, Lazy River LLC.
Yeah.
So I can't believe it wasn't taken.
The trails being there.
What's that?
Do you serve the campus now, ATV trails?
Trails to help you out.
Yeah.
I think your opportunity outside of that lies, will lie within your store.
Yeah.
You know, having an opportunity, you know, it may even be something that you'd want to keep open in the winter for snowmobilers as a place to stop. So I think the opportunity for you, having the amount of parking that you're going to have, having, you know, the campground, being able to close that off in October is certainly be nice. But I think you, there'll be other opportunities there for you.
The.
Give you a place where you'll be done.
I'm sick of it by then.
Up here, this little punch out you see right there is also going to have, if we can get it done correctly and get it approved, three permanent stations for food trucks.
For who?
Food trucks.
Oh.
So that the food truck can come in, set up, it already has its water, electricity and everything it needs right there.
Pulling some competition.
More than coffee.
That way, if we have any kind of events or anything in those common areas or the drive-in, the temporary drive-in screen that you can put up and take down for the side-by-sides and golf carts, there could be food trucks there too, and they're approved main kitchens. So we don't have to serve any food that isn't prepackaged. They can go and get it from the truck and enjoy fresh food.
So did we approve the tabling of the application for now?
Yes.
Okay.
With you abstaining.
Yes.
Okay. So I think we've taken up enough of your time for now. You guys, you already know the overall work.
Yes.
We appreciate giving you.
Thank you for listening to us.
Yes, we're working with you through this.
Awesome. Awesome.
Hopefully we can give you more information. Start.
And when the hopefully new surveyor finishes out a real plan, they'll be hopefully much bigger and to scale.
In a perfect world, when do you want your project complete?
I'd like.
If you have a question, you don't have to answer.
2025 would be for this process to be complete.
Before you stop building?
Before we stop building. Because I figured, like I said, this process is going to take a couple of years just for approval and to make sure everything's in a row.
You've got a big project, so.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's going to be giving you guys some.
And it'll probably be 3 to 5 years before everything is complete, and then it's never complete, right? So it's, there's always going to be something that needs to be done, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're probably looking at 7 to 8 years to, till the house is in, all the sites are in, everything's there. But that's why we wanted to get going now, because we know this is going to be a long process.
Again, Desiree brought up a good point, so when you talk to your surveyor, I would talk to him about phases.
Yeah.
Just a personal recommendation, that's not required.
Absolutely.
Jesus, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I don't care what happens, I just think. All right, so we're good.
All right, thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you so much.
We'll meet with Saco River in January, and we'll get the surveyor going, and hopefully we can come back to you maybe before spring with something a little more substantial and more to what you're looking to see. All right, excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Have a good holiday season.
Merry Christmas to you, too.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
And this is the portion that we are open to public comments, sir. How are you?
Good.
Good.
What do you want me to talk about?
What do you want? I don't have my contacts, and I do not know how you take it as you meant.
That's all right. Well, you all know I'm Jeff Fry in Parsonsfield, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I was just wondering about the select board video, planning board videos for October, November. They're not up.
Desiree?
Sorry?
Any board videos?
Last meeting, we didn't set up the camera because we were here less than 10 minutes. Other than that, the video should be posted.
For October, November?
November, there isn't a video for November, but the October one should be posted.
Our meeting was 4 minutes long, Jeff, in November.
Yeah.
Okay.
Literally, there was nothing on it.
It probably should just say no video available.
They should. Well, I'll talk to them. I think that we're still making some adjustments to the front office. So I'll...
Yeah, okay.
If you don't mind, I'll talk to Daniel.
And the town website said the meeting was December 14th for...
They brought that up at the selectmen's meeting. I don't know if you were there. I watched it online.
I was there.
And they brought it up that there was a missed date on the calendar.
Right. And the Z... Well, you guys aren't in charge of the ZBA. Desiree, you're the ZBA secretary, too?
Mm-hmm.
The homepage is in the dates of the ZBA page. You can't read the dates because the homepage is in the middle of it or to the left of it. Not that anybody looks at those things, but I guess...
Oh, the months, yeah.
I do, because I'm just not ready to be.
Yeah.
Okay. So, from what I hear, everybody had some, a little bit of input on the campground.
I would say we have a ton of input. We know this is a massive project. They're not ready to even...
Right, right. But nobody on the board brought up the plantation. Well, you brought up the plantation. It's a great access point. But maybe the plantation should realize what's going to happen because there's going to be a lot... They're talking golf carts, but are they golf carts? You said golf carts.
You didn't say golf carts, and you didn't say side by side. I think that the plantation... management, because it's not an actual person, should attend as an abutter.
Right, because they're going to be, it's going to cause a lot of traffic.
They have the right to attend as an abutter.
Right.
Right.
And they were notified, and they will be notified again when we get a completed application.
The plantation management, if I'm not mistaken, is a logging company.
It is.
Right.
I don't think they're going to have any concerns. I mean, you know, it's a...
Well, Parsonsfield has an easement to use the plantation as far as four-wheeling and snowmobiling and hunting. And they have ATV trails and snowmobile trails through the plantation. Now, once when you do this, this is basically a commercial Disneyland for four-wheelers. And so they're going to come, and then they're going to, with their club or whatever it is, 193. You said 193, but it changed to 300.
Mm-hmm.
Is that 193 is the first phase and 300 is the second phase?
No, he said 193 was what we have for a plan. He said that
right.
The surveyor said he could fit up to 300.
Right, so technically, he could do 300.
I mean, once we get a plan, yeah.
Well, that's sort of like what we had in town. You know, you start off small, and then you just get a little bit more,
well, we
and a little
be
bit
very
more.
Cautious of how we go forward with this.
There's a lot of people. Yeah, this
and
is.
It is very close to the plantation. So
population
impact isn't huge.
Yeah.
It looks like they're trying to contain, in every entrepreneur's world, you're containing your population to your own property so they don't leave it. But I know that for a fact because I'm surrounded by campgrounds that that's not the case. You want them to keep their dollars there. There could be a good economic benefit to places in town as well. But we also have to look at that it's a permissible use in this zone. So that's why we're treading carefully. I'm not saying whether I agree or don't agree.
Yeah, I'm just...
That's why I suggested...
I know nobody likes change. and people come to Parsons Field because they like Parsons Field and whatever. You know, and you just, this is, of course, this is taking advantage of the resources they got. They got the river, they got the plantation, perfect. I'll spend whatever and get these RVs in there. You could have a lot of traffic, so now we're gonna have to get more, we're gonna have to get another deputy because we're gonna need one. Because there's gonna be complaints that these four-wheelers are driving up and down the road and, you know, we already have it now, but when you have somebody with a lot of money, and I'm not judging people by how much money they have, but you're gonna have like a giant four-wheeler club.
Well, to me, it sounds like they're in the very beginning of their dream stage. They haven't gotten a great feedback from the showman of what is good there. I mean, I did chuckle at them when they said they wanted to put a pop-up movie tent that I spent $3,000 on one and picked up out of the woods the first night we used it. So there's a lot of realism that will come to them, I think, as they continue to develop and find that this plan gets...
I don't doubt that, you know, and, you know, the time scale they're looking at and the amount of money they're looking at, there's a possibility this may never happen. You know, that's the one piece, or it may happen, they're smaller.
Right.
Their realism, I don't think it's going to address Jeff's concern.
I agree.
You know, so that's something that concerns me too, is what impact this is going to have. We got, like you said, we got this beautiful area. We want people to come see it. We don't want to destroy it in the process. So we got to kind of delegate balance to a certain
extent. I feel you, because I think, Jeff, most of these people are going to be coming up 153 to get where they're going. People already use my road in front of my house like it's a drag strip.
Right.
You know,
right.
I literally watched someone come about 6 inches on right from 74 to the mill today and going about 65 miles an hour. So I think we have to address all those things.
Yeah, it's just, and we already have a campground in Parsons Field, I believe. Right.
Windsong?
Yeah, Windsong. Is it in Parsons Field?
This isn't the first one we're going to see. I mean, I've been hearing down the grapevine that there's other. Can you make the workshop on January 4th?
What is the 4th?
Wednesday?
Yep.
2 weeks.
I know it's very close to the beginning of New Year.
I think so.
Okay. I know you have to go, so.
Huh?
I know you have to go.
So I gotta go. I'm gonna take care of something.
Yep.
Just one other question. Does anybody know who the tree warden is in Parsons Field?
I do not.
Okay. No.
That's that old lady, you know, she's on the board that's redoing the comprehensive plan.
She's the tree warden?
I think she is. She's, yeah, I've heard her mention that.
When? Or?
No, the older lady that's...
Jen Lewis?
I don't, what's the real thing in there?
Jen Lewis.
Okay, ask her, I think she has something to do with that.
Okay, I didn't see it. Well, I know the position's been open for 2 years.
Okay.
It's in your town report. Don Winslow used to be your tree warden.
I just sent an email to her and asked her if she's a tree warden.
Okay. All right. And it's just campground tree warden, sort of goes together.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like I said, unofficially, I know that there's someone else working on developing a campground that doesn't really throw me personally. But
we're having a very Christmas. You too, Merry Christmas, Alan.
Thank you, Alan. That's the first one we're going to have to give us the pressing on what to do next. I think ever since COVID, people have been driven north more and more for vacation versus international travel.
Yeah.
I think our workshop is a necessary thing to go over a lot of what we're thinking and what we need to process and how to...
We can't review a specific application in a workshop, though, correct?
You should.
No, we cannot.
Yeah.
But we can go over procedures, regulations,
that would be great. Yeah,
that kind of stuff.
Yep.
You know, awesome. We can look at all that, but we can't.
We may want to come up with a contact list of things for outside of our group, for like the state, and we can include that.
It's not going to be a timeshare, right?
What is this campground? We don't know yet, but I think what if I gather what model they're following, I think it's like some other similar ones. You rent it. You don't timeshare it. You rent your campsite for the year. Some of them do multiple year leases, and you bring your RV in once and you park it.
Yep.
And then it goes out at the end. and most people have a tow behind car. I don't see a ton of them towing behind side-by-sides, but I'm sure they do.
Oh, yeah. Well, they have a lot of campers now that call toy haulers that actually tow the side-by-side inside.
I think they're gonna need something like fuel on the side. I think that's gonna come up with something.
Well, exactly. I think that's what I was kind of thinking about the store is there's going to be additional things. They're gonna need to be able to fill propane. Most of these RVs run on propane. There's gonna be a lot of this that. There's a lot of pieces to a campground that we have to talk to with this plan. You know, the 4x4 bathroom that they have, that pool, you know, that needs to have. You know, and so I think, you know, they're very early. It'll be interesting to see what the next iteration looks like. And we'll go from there, but we'll see.
You know, I'm concerned about 4x4s. Right, we still.
The one, well, we don't have ours.
Yeah, just for that reason.
But that's a technical thing, I guess. All right, so Jeff, more questions? I'm sorry.
No, when he brought up propane, I was thinking they could get propane at the hardware store.
Who knew that was coming?
I would hope they would, if this project ever comes to fruition, they would spread their money throughout. Because I think everyone can use it these days. Any more questions? Comments? Want to get last talking?
Oh, it's just, no. No, I mean, I have them, but I don't. I just gotta keep them inside for now.
Sometimes I let the voices inside talk to me. Can I get a motion about a workshop for January 4th? This workshop is regarding procedures and policies.
I'm going to hold a workshop on Wednesday, January 4th, 2023, to discuss old business A and B, as well as any additional items.
6 o'clock PM?
6 o'clock PM on that day, as well as to discuss any additional items around ordinances.
Do I have a second?
Can I make an amendment, please? Pursuant to the chairman providing us with coffee and ink.
I always ask, can you have pizza?
Hospitality.
Second?
That's so good.
On paper. Well, I'll email Alan, I'm not getting up, like, when you're trying to have a special town meeting, you need to show up. That was totally what they're running my mouth. Motion to adjourn, just a second on that.
Second.
On paper. Everyone have a wonderful Christmas. Jack, you and Mary.
Yeah, thank you.